Avon Wolfkist, is that you?
Do I know you?
You were too young to remember me, but I stayed with your household many years ago. This is for you.
The mead horn of Suttungr. How is this possible? Can you conjure things from dreams?
Yes, it's only a model. I fashioned it from a story told to me by your father, but since he's dead, I offer it to you.
It is exactly like I saw it. In my head. As Varin described it to me. Have you made other things from stories?
Only if the storyteller is very good. Your father was. He would have made a good skald.
Could you do it from dreams or visions? Bring something into this world from another?
Not all dreamers speak, and fewer yet speak clearly. Seers talk too much and cloud your vision with...
What's this about bringing things into this world from another?
More like imagining it into our world. When I have the image, its design speaks to me in a language I do not know, and yet understand.
This is Suttungr's mead horn, Valka, from Jotunheim, as Varin described it to him.
I do not like this business of trafficking in visions. But if it revives good memories of your father, there may be value in it. I will bring you a potion that will let Eivor dream and speak clearly. If you take advantage, your death will be painful.
Nah, you need not go to so much trouble. You could give me the recipe.
I will bring you a potion. Do not dig too deeply. We do not know the true cost of this.
There'll be no cost to the gods. You heard him. He does not take things from their realms. He imagines them, then crafts them.
Not the cost to the gods. To you.
I will get the workshop ready. Come by when you want to get started. You'll be safe in my care. Valka has promised that any harm you suffer will be visited upon me tenfold.
She is protective of her people. But I must exact a promise from you. You must not speak of this to anyone. Whatever happens.
I swear upon my life, I will not speak of this to any but you. near the Raven. My memory is sharp. My aim unbottled. Down there in Niflheim, things are less clear. You know I cannot take you. I can barely get myself through the warding wall, and only then by abandoning my trusted weapons. Do not sulk. I will not risk you. For who then would remind me of my purpose? Yes, Balder, my son. The light of the world locked away in Hel's dark castle. He was taken too soon, stolen from us. I shall not rest till I have denied destiny and brought Balder back from the dead. You're right, Munin. If it is to be done, best it were done quickly. It is time to go to Hel. Niflheim's riches are doubly defended. I must kill the guards before disarming the shield. rules of death are different here. Looks like a warrior of rank. Perhaps he carries some prize on his person. You try.
The King of Thieves welcomes all who wish to bargain fairly and freely.
Can I expect fair treatment from one holding so dubious a title?
I was once a common thief, fighting over scraps, picking corpses clean of all that could be bartered or sold. But now, as their sovereign, the rogues of Niflheim trust me with their traffic, and you may do the same.
I may offer trade, but my trust is not easily earned.
Fine by me. I'm not looking to make friends, only deals. Are you interested?
Show me your stock.
I make a monument of your bones.
I granted you this realm, child.
but I will unmake it if you deny me Balder.
You gave me a barren world, filled with the dishonored and other undesirables. I gave them purpose.
What purpose? An afterlife of constant death?
No. A new kind of life. One free from the fear of death. All who serve me shall have their rebirth. Oh.
You are good with animals.
I'm skilled at killing all manner of things.
think you can keep me out? I pulled your realm out of Ymir's ass! I will send it hurtling back to the void if I have to.
I do not think they can hear you, old man.
Have you come to lend us aid, my son?
I have news from home. War rattles the gates of Asgard while you dally in this dream of rescuing Baldur.
My whole life I've defied expectations by doing the unthinkable. How could I do any less when your brother's life is at stake?
My stepbrother is dead. There is no life at stake. You are full of advice to all who will listen, but deaf to anyone else.
Can you name anyone with more wisdom than I? Who has fought and fallen and sacrificed more than I have?
No.
Then I hope you will understand, son, why I do not take counsel easily.
So, you're going back. Back to Niflheim.
As many times as it takes.
Thank you.
Relax. You're in Ravensthorpe, in my workshop. How do you feel? What do you remember from your dream?
Very little, but I am filled with a sense of urgency.
That makes sense based on what I've heard here. But it is all in your mind. You should take a break from this now. Would you like to see what you have inspired?
Let me see.
have you returned, old one?
Why do you not face me, Queen of the Shamed? Or better yet, give me back my son, and I shall leave you in peace.
I can shape dead flesh into new life. Summon an army with a whisper. What makes you think you still have power over me?
Then why would you not show your true self? What is it you fear?
My fear is beyond your imagining. Your fear, however, is well known among the dead.
Thank you.
thou one of Hell's foul experiments gone awry? What shameful crime could have earned so twisted a fate?
It's not that nor near, but you and that bitch Brynhild who made me thus. Have you betrayed so many gods, Oathbreaker, that you no longer recognize their king?
Jomgunna, why has Hell raised you as this grotesque monstrosity?
I rebuilt myself from abandoned appendages and discarded flesh. A labor of loathing, fueled by vengeance and driven by hate. Thank you.
repair these bridges when they just fall apart?
I mean no offense, but it does seem a pointless task.
Such is life among the dead. The corruption what eats at these bridges is fed by the same hands who demand their maintenance.
And whose hands are those?
The hands of Nidhogg. A twisted collection of druids, mystics, and priests who serve the ruler of these pestilent islands.
Nidhogg. I know that name. A creature whose depravity is legendary. He reigns here?
Aye. Drinking the sap of Yggdrasil's roots, while his hands gather the living and dead for him to feast upon.
And the ones responsible for the rot that eats at these bridges. If I eliminate them, it would ease my passage through here.
Nidhogg is the true root of the rot, but cutting away his hands would slow its spread. You could start with my owner. He's a dark druid who patrols this area, dressed to inspire terror and loathing.
Appears to shimmer here, much in the way it does when the Jotun weave their illusions. Thank you. feels like a trap. I shall make better use of this than Hell's officer would. Easy now. Something is not right. Need to be careful here. hospitality without a host. Are these drinks for the dead, or might anyone partake? That note may shed some light. Which one shall I choose? By my loins, I feel refreshed. What drink is it? Generosity has its limits. Me your foul breath, worm.
So the Our Father seeks his son. I too am fond of my young. They are the most comforting of fools.
A worthy plan. Call your kind into oblivion. They bring nothing to the worlds.
Terror. Pain. Death. These are not nothing. If I will be happy, show you!
You
throughout the land. His intentions help.
What a rare pleasure to meet one of my tasters in person. Few make it this far.
Tasters or testers?
It is all the same. Hell is focused on results, while I'm more interested in the overall experience. I have ordered unmanned stations set up throughout Niflheim so that volunteers may sample free from pressure or bias.
How can you measure reactions if no one is there to witness them?
The choice of beverage indicates which are more appealing, while the cause of death is usually obvious even to the untrained eye.
Cause of death? If murder is the goal, there are more effective means.
That I meant to say cause and effect. Regardless, I am eager to observe firsthand. Help yourself to a drink.
This must be the secret sommelier who leaves drinks throughout the land. Which one shall I choose?
Berries, bile! It burns my throat!
This must be the secret sommelier who leaves drinks throughout the land. His intentions helpful or harmful? Passage forward.
Easy now. Something is not right.
Thank you.
persistent, Hobby.
Where is Balder?
And single-minded. Tell me, what do you think of my home? How does it compare to your early memories of the place?
Strange. I cannot recall how it was in the past. Nevertheless, this place feels oddly familiar. That is neither here nor there. Where is my son? Where is Balder?
He is dead and beyond your reach. What will it take for you to accept that?
Nothing short of hearing it from Balder's own lips.
I know you better than you think, Harvey. Even his word would not suffice.
Bring me to Balder, or prepare for battle.
What do you think I've been doing?
Now that you know who holds real power here, give me my son.
I knew this plan was doomed to fail. It is a hard thing to separate memory from a man without destroying both.
So you have been affecting my memories. Why? Why go to such effort to cloud my thoughts and blunt my will?
The process was not a total failure after all. You really do not remember this was Baldur's idea.
Baldur would never use me thus.
He could serve the greater purpose. He planned everything, but left the execution to me. My only concession was not killing you.
But why would you help him? What do you stand to gain?
Is it so hard to believe that one who has seen so much death could be drawn to the light?
I need to hear this from his lips.
That can be arranged.
Balder.
Hello, Father. Welcome to my sanctuary. Not much, but it will serve till the end of this world.
Hell told me a tale. I did not want to believe it.
All of it is true. To fulfill my destiny, my enemies must think me dead. I cannot risk them learning otherwise. Not even from you.
Who are these enemies? I will wipe them from the world.
It is not your fight, Father. This struggle will stretch well beyond your final battle.
So you tried, relieving me of my memories. But if that did not work...
You must sacrifice, Mudin. Your memories will not be lost, I will keep them safe. And I will gift you a new raven, Sunin, to help you look forward.
There's so much I want to say.
We do not value the time we have until there is nothing left. But we have already exchanged more goodbyes than you know.
Balder, you're the one pure thing I've brought into the worlds. That is why I need you back. You help balance things.
I feel your love, Father. The memory will warm me. But your world belongs to darkness, and I must bring light to a new age.
Then rip it from my heart. Sear it from my skull. Leave no trace of a feeling for you. Else, life will be unbearable.
You will bear it. Goodbye, Father.
Took you down this time, epoxy troll. Father, what is it? What has happened? Did you find Balder?
Balder, yes. I'm here to rescue him. Have you come to lend us aid, my son?
No. I did not want to...
This is about more than Balder. She has a plan. I see it now, more clearly than before.
Father... There is something you should know. Something... You did know.
I do not want to hear it. Not if it will distract me from my mission.
Wait. I know what you are about to say.
Say you held the Midgard serpent in your arms, poised to snap its neck. What could dislodge you from that embrace?
Nothing. Not even death. So... You will be going back then.
As many times as it takes.
Where is he? Where is he gone?
Calm down, Eivor. You're safe in Ravensthorpe.
That was just a dream, was it not? A dream of fathers and sons and daughters.
Perhaps something more than that. Yours is not the first family torn asunder. Nor will it be the last.
Aye, it is a story older than time.